Following the flagging off of repair works on Saturday, no more traffic is expected to resume on Karuma Bridge after 3 months. Musa Echeru, the Minister of State for Works and Transport, handed over the site to the contractor and flagged off the construction works. He said the government is grateful to the public for the patience exhibited since the bridge was closed.
The long-awaited day for the repair of this strategic bridge, the Karuma Bridge, has arrived. It is true, a few weeks back, the government sent me to this bridge to close it because of the risk that it posed to the traveling public. And the gratitude that we as government are extending to the citizens is for the patience they have exhibited from the time we closed this bridge.
Thank you.
And continue, we are requesting them to continue to give us the same patience for the next 3 months.
The Karuma Bridge was closed to heavy vehicles on May 6th after engineers identified threatening defects on its bearings. The bridge, constructed in 1963, connects Lango, Acholi, West Nile regions to the rest of the country. It also connects South Sudan and the northern part of DRC. The contract for repairs was awarded to China Railway 7th Group Co. Limited in joint venture with the National Enterprise Corporation at a cost of 7 billion shillings. Edith Alinguma Adieri, the Chiriandongo District Chairperson, appealed to the government to introduce the ferry to connect Oyama and Chiriandongo districts through Mutunda and Atura.
Morning for us as Chiriandongo District and the neighboring districts and the whole nation for us within this works to allow even the heavy trucks and the rest tomorrow for safety of all the Ugandans who will be transiting over this road. So I want to thank the ministry together with the government of Uganda for all the efforts that they have made.
John Amos Okot, the Agago North Member of Parliament, called on the public to be patient until the bridge is reopened.
So this is a great, great work and the response that you are doing. And indeed, we spoke on behalf of them and we spoke loudly so that the work should be done and should be done quickly and faster.
Uganda has asked the Kenyan government to lower the bond fees of $40 million at an oil storage terminal it uses to ferry petroleum products from Mombasa to Kampala. This follows the recent commencement of direct importation of refined petroleum products by the Uganda National Oil Company through the Mombasa port in Kenya. In a post on her X account yesterday, Ruth Nankabira, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, said Kenya has increased the bond fee to a tune of $40 million at the Vito terminal.
For as long as we are not pushed to incur costs at the port, because as I speak now, I'll be going back to Kenya to meet my colleague, Narego Chichi, because of one thing, they have increased the bond fee at Vito terminal, where we are going to offload our products.
On July 3rd, 2024, UNOC successfully received its first shipment comprising 78 million liters of petrol and 65,000 tons of diesel at Kipevu Oil Terminal 2 in Mombasa.
I am still in the negotiations with the Kenyan government to make sure that they don't force on us this kind of thing. The bond fee at VTTI in Mombasa, that is Vito Terminal in Mombasa, where we are storing our products.
This development followed months of anticipation and extensive agreements with Kenyan authorities. Uganda is currently a net importer of petroleum products, where more than 90% are imported through the Mombasa port in Kenya and the rest through the Dar es Salaam port in Tanzania. The importation was being done independently by the licensed oil marketing companies through the importation structures in Kenya and Tanzania. French voters turned out in numbers yesterday for the second round of a historic election that is expected to leave the far right as the biggest force in a deeply divided parliament. At midday, according to the Interior Ministry figures, some 26.63% of voters had turned out for the high-stakes poll, the highest number at the time since 1981. President Emmanuel Macron called the snap elections 3 years ahead of time after his forces were trounced in June's European Parliament vote, a gamble which seems to have backfired. Far-right leader Marine Le Pen's national rally came top in the June 30th first round and is on course to repeat the feat in the runoff races. But she may not win the outright majority that would force Macron to appoint Le Pen's lieutenant, the RN party leader, Jordan Bardella, 28, as prime minister, just weeks before Paris hosts the Olympics. And in Rome, Pope Francis chose the day for the French vote to warn against ideological temptations and popularists, adding democracy is not in good health in the world today. With the country on tenterhooks, last week saw more than 200 tactical voting pacts between centre and left-wing candidates in seats to attempt to prevent the RN winning an absolute majority.
La parola stessa democrazia non coincide semplicemente con il voto del popolo. Nel frattempo a me preoccupa il numero ridotto della gente che è andata a votare. Cosa significa?
Opinion polls now forecast the RN will fall well short of the 289 seats needed for an outright majority in the 577-seat National Assembly, while still becoming the largest party.